শুধু দর্শক শ্রোতা, ক্যালিফোর্নিয়া টেলিভিশনের নিয়মিত আয়োজন অনুপ্রেরণা, সে সকল গুণী পণ্ডিত যারা জীবনের অনেকটা সময় নিজেকে সাধনার মধ্যে ডুবে রেখেছেন, তেমন একজন মানুষ পণ্ডিত রামদাস পালসোলেজি। তিনি পুনে ভারত থেকে সংযুক্ত হচ্ছেন আজকে আমাদের অনুষ্ঠানে। আমরা পণ্ডিতজিকে ডেকে নিচ্ছি। পণ্ডিতজি নমস্তে।
নমস্তে স্বামীজি, নমস্তে।
হাউ আর ইউ পণ্ডিতজি?
আই এম ফাইন, হাউ আর ইউ স্বামীজি?
I'm good. Welcome to today's show.
Thank you so
in
much
our
for
program Inspiration. So we are looking beside of you, the accompanist. Do you favor to introduce them?
Sure. I will be accompanied on harmonium by a wonderful young talented harmonium player, Abhishek Shinkar. And I will be also accompanied by two of my disciples, Yash Soman and Prathamesh Amarule. So we all will perform together.
Wow. Panditji, today we would like to dedicate this program to your Guruji.
या ताल योगी पंडित सुरेश तळवलकर जी,
या विथ रिस्पेक्ट आई एम रिक्वेस्टिंग यू टू स्टार्ट टुडे प्रोग्राम एंड बिफोर गोना शो योर परफॉर्मेंस आई हैव अ क्वेश्चन टू यू अबाउट योर म्यूजिक जर्नी, योर साधना विथ तबला.
Yeah, it is a quite interesting story because I had never thought that I would become a tabla player, professional tabla player. I used to like tabla a lot. It was passion for me. And I started learning at very early age of maybe seven, when I was 7 years old. I learned from Samanta Guruji, who were running Tabla Academy very close to my old house. And I learned from him for four or five years maximum. Then what happened, when I got admission to higher school in fifth grade, so the school name was Jnana Prabodhini. It is a very different kind of school, and there were lots of activities other than just school education. So I was not able to get time to go to learn tabla from Samant Guruji. So my tabla learning was cut short. Then it went on for 10, 12 years. I was not learning tabla and I was not playing tabla at all. So it was a big gap, 10, 12 years. Then after I completed my mechanical engineering graduation, after that, I heard my Guruji once playing tabla solo in in Pune, and I was mesmerized. And the passion, though I was not playing tabla, but the passion in the inside was still there. So that passion surfaced, and I thought I should again start learning tabla. So I went to him and asked him whether I can learn tabla from him. So he inquired all the things and said, "Yeah, you are engineer and I don't teach tabla for hobby. If you want to learn seriously 24/7, then only you can come to me and learn tabla." So I left my job, which I was doing at that time as a mechanical engineer. And I went to Mumbai where he was staying. I'm staying in Pune, and that time he was staying in Mumbai. So I went to his place. I stayed with him for 5-6 years and gave my complete those years to my Guruji. And it was 24/7, only tabla and only tabla. And that's how I came back to the music world. But still, I was never thinking that I should become a tabla, professional tabla player. So after the continuous learning of 5-6 years, we call it talim. After the talim, I came back to Pune and I started my engineering business again. And I used to go to my Guruji's place every weekend. And that went on for, again, 10, 12 more years. I was doing my business as well as learning tabla. And slowly, slowly, the concert invitations started coming. And I reached at a situation in around year 2000 that now I would like, I don't do both the things, because either I should do business or I should do tabla. So at that time, I decided to do only tabla. So actually, my career as a professional tabla player started at during year 2000. So last 20 years, now I am full-time into tabla. And this journey of learning from Guruji was is a golden period of my life. So I because my English is not so good, I cannot explain it to you in the exact words, but I can say that this talim from Guruji, those 5-6 years, and still it is going, but those 5-6 years, I was completely immersed into that talim from Guruji. And I think that is the golden period of my life. And that talim could help me to become a good tabla player, good tabla performer. So that's how my tabla journey is.
Pandit ji, actually language is not factor. You can share with us through Hindi, whatever you feel comfort. It's not mandatory to talk about through English. People will be know the tabla sound. It's little bit different. So I have another question about your practice with your Guruji. If I don't mistake, I have the name.
My Guruji's name.
Suresh Talwalkarji, right?
Yeah.
Suresh Talwalkarji. How long years ago continuously you did practice?
Yeah, it was in, I started learning from him in 1986. Oh. I graduated from engineering college on 1984. And I was doing a job as a mechanical engineer in a German company.
Got it. And there is another question. What's the technique especially Guruji told you? Sureshji, what's the technique?
No, see, his talim included everything, like Shastra, Tantra, Vidya and Kala.
Okay.
These are four pillars of Indian classical music.
Shastra, Tantra, Vidya, Kala.
Kala. Shastra
wow.
means all the what to do, what not to do. When you perform Hindustani classical music, including tabla. So
wow.
Then comes that tantra. Tantra means technique.
Technique.
In our tabla language, it means nikas. How to play all the syllables ideally so that the ideal sound comes from tabla.
Nika?
So that is tantra.
Tantra.
Tantra. And tantra. Tantra is, perfect tantra is required for the best tonal quality as well as the speed.
Oh.
Speed of the playing.
Got it.
That technique. Eh? Then Vidya. Vidya is the, tabla is around 500 years, more than 500 years old instrument. And it is the most popular percussion instrument in the world. And many stalwarts in the past have composed so many compositions, thousands of and thousands of compositions. So that is the Vidya of tabla.
Wow. So today
nobody can claim that he knows all the compositions of tabla. It is so vast,
very wide. Right.
Yeah. So Shastra, Tantra, Vidya and Kala. See, this Shastra, Tantra and Vidya, they are the, you can say, raw material or in raw ingredients.
Raw ingredients.
When you learn these things from Guru, you get the samskara of Guru. When you are having talim from him, when you are staying with him 24/7, then you get samskar from Guru, and that samskar is essential to convert all this raw material into kala, into the art. So Shastra, Tantra, Vidya added with this talim of Guru or samskar received from Guru, then it becomes your kala. And that, in Guru Shishya Parampara, this is very essential to be with Guru 24/7, to stay with him and to get talim by him. And that is what we mean in our Guru Shishya Parampara.
Wow, it's really important.
Yeah. The speciality or of my Guruji is that he is just not a tabla guru. He is a complete musician because he has stayed, he has performed with many stalwarts, mainly vocalist, instrumentalist, Kathak dancers. And he himself see Pandit Gajanan Bua Joshi and Pandit Nivrutti Bua Sarnaik as his gurus, because he was fortunate to stay with them, accompany with them on stage for so many years. So he was as good as their disciple, Pandit Nivrutti Bua Sarnaik and Pandit Gajanan Bua Joshi's disciple. They both also treated him as their disciple, and I am sure he is equally knows so many vocal khayal bandishe and khayal and chota khayal, bada khayal, compositions. He know a lot of them. I'm sure he's at par with any vocalist, or maybe he may be knowing more compositions of vocal music than any vocalist. So he's a complete musician. So during the talim, we didn't get the talim of only tabla, but we got the talim of whole music. We got the talim of vocal, we got the talim of kathak dance, we got the talim of how to accompany with the instrumentalist, everything. So he's a complete musician, and that is why not just tabla players, but the vocalists, instrumental players, even kathak dancers, they are also learning from my Guruji. That is his greatness.
Yeah. So, great opportunity to know about Guruji. So, a lot of viewers, they are watching our show. Right now, can we enjoy your performance? Like a tutorial to our beginners?
Sure. So, I would like to perform a concept created by my Guruji only.
Wow.
It is very unique concept.
Mm-hmm.
He has conceptualized one pattern of compositions in Taal Teen Taal. And that pattern is 9-4-6-4-9.
9-4-6-4-9.
Yeah, 9 plus 4, 13. 13 plus 6,
19
plus 4, 23. 20. And 23 plus 9, 32.
Okay.
So this pattern fits into Taal Teen Taal. And I will try to play one peshkar, short peshkar, a couple of one kaida, one reela, everything based on this pattern, 9-4-6-4-9.
Wow. But there is a question, Panditji. Commonly the Teen Taal is dadindinda, like 16 bit, right? Natindinda, tarindinda. So you say it's different style, but it will be rounding like.
Teen Taal is the same. We have divided that Teen Taal into this pattern, 9-4-6.
Wow. Okay.
But the composition goes in this pattern, 9-4-6-4-9.
Okay.
I will first demonstrate you how it works.
And we are eagerly waiting to see.
Take me down. See. In this layer, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you can count 4 times 8. So it makes 32 from in 1 hour time, in one cycle, from first sum to next sum. So I will divide this 32 counts in the pattern 9-4-6-4-9. So this is the pattern of composition, or you can say this is the meter I'm going to use for all compositions. So my peshkar will be also on the same meter. And my Kaida and Rela, everything will be same on this meter. I will try. Hope you enjoy. This represents the pattern 94649. Thank you.
Thank you.
This is what I cannot hear you, Swamiji.
Yes. Huh. Right now.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
It's okay.
So
there is a lot of comment. So I think I should read it. Nayonesh P. Mehta. Wow, wow, kya baat. A lot of disciples and you student and also viewers from different part of world.
Yes.
Venugopal Joshi. Wow. Anahat Nath. ओमकार अनाहद नाथ। देवादित्य फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश, कोटि कोटि प्रणाम।
गॉड ब्लेस यू।
प्रणाम लाकी সরকার। আহা কিছু বলার নেই, মনটা ভরে গেল। সো শি ইজ ফুলফিলড
থ্যাংক ইউ সো
মেন্টালি,
মাচ।
নো স্পিচ। বেণুগোপাল কিয়া বাত হ্যায়, আহা কিয়া বাত। সুরে সু
সুরেখ মিন্স
সুরে
ইয়া
এস ইউ আর ই
ওয়ান্ডারফুল
কে
ওয়ান্ডারফুল ইট ইজ ইন মারাঠি।
আ
সুরেখ
মারাঠি ওয়ার্ড।
ইয়া
ও ওকে, আই লার্নড আয়ুষ ঠেলগোট। প্রণাম দাদা। ওকে, ও মাই গড, আ লট অফ কমেন্ট, লেটস সি। ওকে, দেয়ার ইজ আ লট অফ কমেন্ট, সো আই উইল শো অন স্ক্রিন। এন্ড পন্ডিত জি, সো ফার্স্ট নেক্সট অ্যাডভাইস এন্ড ইনফরমেশন ফ্রম ইউ, উই উড লাইক টু লার্ন এন্ড অলসো দ্য ভিউয়ার্স।
Actually, I would like to continue first with my performance. I have thought of playing some fixed compositions like Chakradhar, Tukde, etc., which are normally played in Chatushra Jati, but now I will play those in Tisra Jati. Same compositions. And it will give you another flavor. Another
okay.
flavor. My Guruji always encourages us to see the same composition from different direction. You have one composition which is starting from some, ending on some, but you can make an anaghat out of it. You can make an atit composition. You can play it in different jati, or you can make the chakradhar out of it. So there are so many ways to look at each composition.
Okay.
So I am trying to now play these compositions which are normally played in Chatushrajat, but I will now play for you and for all the viewers in Tisrajat. I will try my best. Ah
Thank you.
So this was the short presentation of Guruji's concept of 94649.
Pandit ji, amazing.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Very unique, really. There is a question from Debaditya Bani, Bangladesh. He's asking, Pandit ji, do Guruji have created any concept on Laggi?
Laggi, yeah. He has... He was fortunate to spend time with the stalwarts like Ustad Thirakwa Kha Sahib, Ustad Amir Hussain Kha Sahib, and Pandit Samta Prasad Ji, and Pandit Kishan Maharaj Ji, many stalwarts, Ustad Allah Rakha Kha Sahib. So he got inspiration of from all of them, and he has developed many new ideas in tabla. He has his approach towards playing a tabla solo is far different from the normal approach. You all may be knowing that he uses the vocal accompaniment for a tabla, his tabla solo performance, and also he takes the his disciples to accompany him on tabla, as well as pakhavaj, as well as Western drums or East European percussion instruments. And that is a unique experience to listen to his tabla solo performance. So he has many concepts. So in Laggi also, normally Guruji accompanies only classical music. So I have got very less opportunities to listen to him laggi, playing laggis. But one laggi which he one laggi nada which he taught to us, I will try to present it to you. This is laggi nada and not laggi. So it is I mean we normally play towards the end of our tabla solo concert. Normally doesn't play laggis and laggi nadas, but he has taught us this laggi nada. And we learned a few luggage, in last month, I carried out a workshop to students, tabla students from Bay Area. And I taught them only luggage for 4 days. Every day, 3 hours.
Oh my God.
So I taught them luggage in Kerwa as well as Dadra as well as Deep Chandi. So this is how we have been fortunate to gather so much of Vidya, to get so much of Vidya from our Guruji.
It's too difficult and matter of patience.
Yeah, that is true. That is true.
Oh my God. I would like to share some memories of you. I think from US.
Yeah, yeah.
Pandit Shapanji.
Yeah. You know, the one fortunate thing in my life is that I share the birth date, same birth date with Pandit Swapanda. Both of us have birth date of 30th of March.
So last year?
I am very fortunate to share birth date with such a maestro, tabla maestro. And every year he calls me and gives me lots of blessings. And I also call him and to say pranam to him. And we have very, very lovely bond between both of us.
Wow. Which state, Panditji, in US? Shapanji?
Yeah, Shapanji stays in US. He stays in near San Francisco.
San Francisco, yeah. Mm-hmm. And this one?
This is my Guruji, Tal Yogi Pandit Suresh Talwarkar Ji.
Yeah.
And behind is my youngest student, Hemant Joshi.
Joshi.
Yeah, Hemant Joshi.
This one also?
This is, he's a very, very brilliant young tabla player who is a, you can say, a child prodigy. His name is Vivek Pandya. And he is a disciple of Pandit Anindo Chatterjee. And he played in my Guru Purnima celebration last year. In Pune.
What's his name?
His name is Vivek Pandya.
Oh.
He stays in US. He stays in US. He stays in New Jersey. And he's very brilliant. Out of the world.
You can maybe see. I met him last 2018 September World Hindu Congress. If I don't make mistake. Maybe. Yeah, this boy.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Got it. And this one?
This one is me.
Little Ramdasji, right?
I was performing of that time Guru, Samant Guruji, in his Guru Purnima celebration. So it was in...
Oh, so on tabla, is this you?
Yeah, it is 1972. Oh. And I am playing tabla solo in front of my Guruji, that time Guruji, Samant Guruji.
Runuji?
Oh, yeah.
You?
No, this is from left. Mukund Rajdev. Mukund Rajdev. The person in the saffron kurta is Mukund Rajdev, a very good, very well-known tabla player from Bombay. Next to him is Pandit Satish Vyas.
Then Runuji.
The Santur maestro. Then next to him is Pandit Ranu Majumdar, who is very close to me, very dear friend of me. And we performed together many places. Even we have traveled a lot in USA and Canada. And have performed 100 times in US itself. And this is again my picture with my Guruji and my some senior student. His name is Ganesh Tanavade. Oh, this is one of my very early days performance with Pandit Vijay Koparkar. Pandit Vijay Koparkar, he was instrumental to bring me back into the music, because he was also a student of my College of Engineering, that is College of Engineering Pune, and he took me back towards the music, and then I started playing tabla again after the gap of 10-12 years. Yeah,
really interesting.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh my god.
Ustad Zakir Bhai, Ustad with me and Devaki Pandit, also very wonderful vocalist from
Devaki, the lady here. She is
Devaki Pandit. Yeah.
Okay.
She is disciple of Pandit Jitendra Abhisheki ji.
Classical vocal.
Yeah, classical vocal.
From which part of India?
She is from Bombay.
Bombay. Okay. And wow, smile Pandit ji there. Wow, you smile, Jaki Hussain ji, and I guess another 2-3, I don't know what's the name.
Yeah, first one is me, then next to me is Ustad Zakir Bhai. Next to him is my Guruji's son, Satyajit Talwalkar. He's also a wonderful tabla player.
The son does?
Then next to him is Niladri Kumar, the sitar maestro.
Oh, yeah.
And next to him is Ustad Taufik Qureshi, Zakir Bhai's younger brother.
Mm.
And next to him is the Mrudangist. Sridhar Partha Sarathi.
Oh, yeah. He is also maestro, right? Midanga.
Yeah.
Got
no, all of them except me, they are from Bombay. Of course, Zakir Bhai is from US, but he's
yes
half in Bombay and half in US.
right. And this one?
Yeah, this is me again with my Guruji and Ustad Zakir Hussain.
You are looking like so young, Panditji.
Thank you so much.
It looks like too young.
I'm young. Yeah. I'm just 57 years young.
Yes, it's good. Wow. It's really good memory.
I was so fortunate to be invited by Ustad Zakir Bhai in Abbaji's Barsi a couple of years back. And I think, I'm not sure, but I think this picture is from that time. Yeah.
Oh, got it. So we are so happy today you shared your memory, your experience, your advice to the beginners of tabla, a lot of their devaditto, and a lot of your tabla young performers there. Someone from Keegan JBR also there. Maybe he's from Pakistan.
Oh.
And a lot of artists and viewers. So we are going to end up the program. And before we're gonna finish, I have personal question to you. The question about, you know, all over the world, because of COVID-19, mentally people are not good. What are your advice and feelings to them?
Actually, you know, for many musicians and for me particularly, this was a blessing in disguise. Because though we were stuck in our homes, I could spend a lot of time in my riyaz, in my sadhana, and also because of the available technology, we can I can interact with my Guruji face to face. I can interact with my students online, and I can learn from my Guruji. Even I could teach my students online, and I spend most of this time in thinking what I have not done in last so many years. So I tried to focus on the things which I have never done in the past, and tried to utilize this available time in widening my playing capacity. So this 9-4-6-4-9 concept to be used for the whole tabla solo, this idea came into mind during this time period only. And I recently performed a full tabla solo performance based on this 9-4-6-4-9 pattern for organization from Australia. And it was a nice thought I felt after that. So even I tried to look all the compositions from different angles, rather than playing in normal way. I tried to mold it into another. Same compositions, but I tried to look them from another angles. Like I said, I never thought earlier that one composition can be looked, can be presented in many ways, like Atit, Anaghat, Chakradhar, Farmaishi Chakradhar, playing it into another Jati, and so many ways. You can transform one compositions in so many varieties. So the thinking towards your own art and looking your own art from various angles, that it was possible due to this COVID-19 time, because there was nothing to do other than the riyaz and thinking. So I hope everybody must have done the same thing. So I think this COVID-19 situation for musicians is the blessing in disguise. Swamiji,
yes,
over to you. Yeah.
Oh yeah. So now I saw the screen is going. That's why I'm looking. There is a comment. We learn a lot of things.
My advice for young musicians and music students is you focus yourself onto your riyaz, your sadhana, and don't get disturbed because of this COVID-19 situation. Mm-hmm. Focus yourself to do your sadhana and keep your keep your needs at minimal level, and I'm sure you will be able to sustain if you keep your all the needs at minimal level and utilize this time for your riyaz and your thinking, thought process. And when you will perform in front of the audience on stage, you will feel that you are transformed into another level. You have achieved another level of your art. I'm sure everybody will experience that.
Right, absolutely, Panditji. And there is a good comment from Shorna Kuntia from Banaras. So nice to see Ramdas Palshule ji on this California television.
Thank
Sharna
you so
ji
much. Thank you.
here and Nayanish P. Mehta. Absolutely true. Very well said, Ramdas ji.
Thank you so much, Nayanish ji.
We learned a lot of things from you, as always. Devaditya said to Pandit ji. And he asked, need you blessings, Pandit ji. Devaditya. And there is another Shaptoshi ji, disciple of Pandit Jasharas ji. He said, Pranam Ramdas ji. Joy ho. Kya baat? Pranam Maharaj ji. Pranam Shaptoshi ji. So, really, it's a good connection. Pandit ji, the viewers, California, India, all over the world. And actually, Pandit ji, I would like to share with you. You advising and sharing your knowledge and your tabla science, tabla knowledge and information about what should we do. Because of COVID-19, we can do a lot of things inside home.
Yeah.
So don't be negative. Be positive.
Be positive. Be positive. Yeah. With thought.
Positive with thought. Yeah. Try to use your energy to inner feelings, practice sadhana. Right. So you're one disciple from Kuwait. So nice to see you, Ramdas ji, from Kuwait. It's always a pleasure to watch you playing. So also I feel that this live session, we are connected all over the world in a music family, one family.
Yeah.
And I feel very good about this point. And today we're going to finish our program. And before going to finish, my request to you to make in conclusion to our viewers and all over world, they are looking to you. What your advice? Then we will conclude our program.
Yeah, my advice is very simple. You know, today's generation has so many distractions. When I was young, we had no computer, no mobile, no even telephone. So we could focus on whatever we were doing. But today, generation is not so fortunate. They have so many distractions. So my advice is don't get distracted. Be focused. Focus on your riyaz, on your sadhana. Focus on your talim from your guru, respective guru. And keep your all needs at minimum level. And if you focus on your music, then concerts, getting opportunities is the byproduct of it. It will come automatically. You will get them automatically. You should focus on your music, on your riyaz, on your sadhana. But sometimes you tend to divert your focus on getting more concerts and getting more opportunities. But don't do that. It will come automatically when you are focused. It will come to you automatically. You will get the wonderful opportunities in your career and have confidence in yourself and your riyaz and your guru. And surrender yourself to your guru. That is my advice.
Wow. So we need to surrender both hands, not one hand.
Yeah.
Panditji?
Yeah.
Both hands, like Draupadi to Krishna, fully surrender.
Yeah.
Then,
correct.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Panditji, to stay connected with California TV. And hopefully we will meet again. And we are praying for you, for your healthy,
you
wealthy
so
life.
Inviting us in this wonderful event of yours, wonderful show of yours, and hopefully we'll meet again.
And I am requesting you to again reintroduce about your accompanist beside of you, please.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, so today I was accompanied by my on tabla by my senior students like Yash Soman and Prathamesh Amrule. They are very brilliant students of me. And I was accompanied equally brilliantly on harmonium by young, upcoming, talented musician from Pune, Abhishek Shinkar. He is disciple of Pandit Pramod Maratheji. So I thank you on behalf of all of us and stay. I request all of you, all the viewers, to stay healthy, stay safe, stay your home, stay at your home, and we will definitely defeat this COVID-19 very soon.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Namaste, Panditji. Namaste.
Namaste. Namaste. Pranam. Pranam.
সুধী দর্শক শ্রোতা, এতক্ষণ ধরে এত সুন্দর একটি সময় আমরা কাটিয়েছি অত্যন্ত একজন গুণী মানুষ পণ্ডিত রামদাস পানসলে। জীবনে সময়গুলো খুব ভালোভাবে কাটিয়েছেন সাধনায়, সেই সাধনার ফসল আজকের এই উপদেশ, যেটাকে আমরা যারা সঙ্গীতের ভাষায়, যারা তালযন্ত্রের বিশেষ অনুরাগী শিক্ষার্থী, তাদের জন্য এটি একটু অনুপ্রেরণা। ক্যালিফোর্নিয়া টেলিভিশনের ইন্সপাইরেশন অনুষ্ঠানটি আমরা তাদেরকে নিয়ে এই অনুষ্ঠানে আমন্ত্রণ করে থাকি যারা নিজের কর্মক্ষেত্রে সফল। পণ্ডিত রামদাস পালসুলে তিনি নিজের কর্মক্ষেত্রে সফল। আমরা ঠিক এই ধরনের গুণীদের কর্মকাণ্ডে শ্রদ্ধা রেখে নিজেদের সময়টুকু আমরা কাজে লাগাব, এটাই আমাদের প্রত্যাশা। তিনি যেমনটি বলেছেন, নতুনদের আজকাল যে সুযোগ সুবিধা ইন্টারনেট, ইউটিউব এবং সেই সাথে যে টিউটোরিয়াল গুলো দেখার, পণ্ডিত রামদাসজি খুব সুন্দরভাবে তিনি উপস্থাপন করেছেন হাউ টু লার্ন, কিভাবে আপনার সময়গুলো আপনি কাজে লাগাবেন। তো আজকে যারা আমাদের অনুষ্ঠান দেখছেন, যে সকল অভিভাবক বৃন্দ এবং সারা বিশ্বের বিভিন্ন প্রান্ত থেকে যে সকল সংস্কৃত অনুরাগী আমাদের অনুষ্ঠানটি উপভোগ করেছেন, আমরা মনে করি আমাদের এই অনুষ্ঠানটি অনেকটা টিউটোরিয়ালের মতো কাজে লাগবে। শেখার আছে, যেমনটি তিনি তাল তিতালকে তিনি ব্যাখ্যা করেছেন বিভিন্ন ছন্দে। তো এখানেই রাখছি, বাংলাদেশ সময় রাত 9টা, ক্যালিফোর্নিয়া সময় সকাল 7টা, ভারতীয় সময় সকাল 8:30, সন্ধ্যে 8:30 আমাদের নিয়মিত আয়োজন নৃত্যার্পণ। তবে অনুষ্ঠানটি বিশেষভাবে সাজানো হয়েছে নৃত্যকলা নিয়ে। এতে উপস্থিত থাকবেন ফাতেমাতুজ্জোহরা এবং আরো কিছু খ্যাতিমান মানুষ বিশ্বের বিভিন্ন প্রান্ত থেকে অনুষ্ঠানটি দেখার জন্য আমন্ত্রণ জানিয়ে আজ এখানে শেষ করছি। ভালো থাকবেন, সুস্থ থাকবেন। Thank you.